Hey, today I'll talk about my must-have utilities for Linux. We'll start pretty big. Number 1. HDOP. Just kidding, systemd resolved. It's a pretty useful software that is very often omitted. Basically, it's a local name resolution service that, in its most basic form, can cache requests so that you're not unnecessarily querying external DNS. But if it only did that, we wouldn't really care as much. For me, the most important aspect of systemd resolved is that it allows you to use multiple DNS servers at once. Consider this, you're connecting to your corporate VPN that exposes you to some intranet domains. With systemd resolved, you can assign DNS servers to the VPN network interface, and then assign domains that should be resolved via that interface's DNS servers. Everything else that is not corp.org goes through the default gateway out to the default DNS. First, if you're using DHCPCD or something else that is actively overwriting etc resolv.conf, disable that feature. For DHCPCD, it's enough if you edit its config file and add nohook resolv.conf at the very end of the file and restart the service. Now, let's edit the resolver service itself. As a root, open etc systemd resolv.conf. You'll probably see everything commented out. So just uncomment DNS and fallback DNS options and give them your server addresses. I suggest you give it IPv4 and IPv6 combo for each one, unless you're not interested into IPv6. You can set multiple DNS servers as primary or fallback, separated by whitespace. Systemd resolved will elect one as primary. I am also enabling DNSSEC and DNS over TLS. Make sure your chosen DNS server supports those options. DNSSEC prevents forging DNS responses, and DNS over TLS is an encryption mechanism thanks to which your queries are not visible to internet operators. Just so you know, if you encounter some problems with captive portals, for example when connecting to Wi-Fi, temporarily disable both of them. They are known to cause problems.
You can enable and force DNSSEC, and then you kind of break your system because loads of people claim that they do DNSSEC and then they missign their domains and basically you can't resolve anything. Also, the captive portals break DNSSEC quite often.
Lastly, enable the service itself and verify that your resolv.conf now points to your loopback address. Resolved's unit should manage that automatically, but if that doesn't happen, just put name server 127.0.0.53 as the only DNS. Use resolv.ctl status to check if settings were loaded correctly and one of your main DNS servers was elected as main. Using dig, part of the bint package, we can verify things a bit further. By default, we can see that our request for google.com for IPv4 and v6 goes through systemd resolved properly, but it's using unencrypted UDP packets. Don't worry, everything works as expected. For local communication within your loopback, traditional UDP packets are being used, but when a resolver forwards queries, it uses TLS since we enabled it. Let's see that once again, but this time while looking at network packets. I'm using TCP dump for capture and I filter by destination, which is my primary DNS. Here's how our DNS TLS query looks like when it's forwarded to the primary DNS. And for contrast, here's how an unencrypted DNS query looks like. As you can see, an unencrypted DNS query has much less packets compared to the TLS one, because it's not establishing a TLS session. Not really an utility, but still. I would recommend getting the ones physically closest to you, or from the same country you're in. It can be noticeably faster to download packages, and also timeouts should occur much less often. Edit the etc pacman.d mirror list, comment out or delete unused mirrors and generate yours using official Pacman mirror list website. CAPS is your go-to solution when it comes to printing on Linux. Getting it to work is as easy as installing the CAPS package and starting the systemd service. CAPS is most often managed via browser. When started, it listens on localhost and port 631. If you ever need to connect to remote CAPS instance, for example at work, create client.conf at /etc/caps and insert server name and your URL. That way, you don't have to configure all of your printers on each of your devices. You can have centralized printing server instance. Docker has become an essential tool for programmers, DevOps or sysadmins. It allows us to quickly run simple software or orchestrate complicated deployments. It has certain flaws, but nonetheless, it is an essential utility that is worth having. In previous tutorials, we've installed nftables as our firewall, and since Docker is not yet fully supporting nftables, we need to install the iptables nft package that will translate iptables rules and put them into our nft rule set. Skip this step if you're not using nftables. Install the package and confirm that it will replace the old iptables package. Now you can grab Docker directly from Arch repo, install Docker and Docker Compose. Start or enable Docker service and enjoy. I've prepared sample Grafana Compose deployment to show you that it works properly. I hope you learned something new today, and if you did, please leave a like.